And unfortunately, sad news to start out here today, including the death of Jimmy Rave, who passed away after a very, very difficult year. He had all sorts of health issues, including getting his arm amputated and then both of his legs amputated, and had been in very, very rough shape of late. Been a lot of fundraisers to help him pay medical bills, six-figure medical bills, and unfortunately passed away, I guess, today.
Yeah, as far as I know, it was today.
December 12th, so it would have been Sunday.
It would have been yesterday. Okay. So I don't really know where to start with him. I mean, I watched his career. You know, I watched him in Ring of Honor when he was getting his first exposure. Actually, I guess his first, I first heard of him in NWA Wildside about 20 years ago, late 90s, early 2000s, with AJ Styles and some of the guys that started there, and then went on to Ring of Honor, and then the Rock and Rave Infection with Christy Hemme and Lance Hoyt, now Lance Archer, doing the guitar player gimmick, you know, the rock band gimmick, and, you know, they were kind of, they were in TNA for a couple years there, kind of as a lower level team, you know, for the most part, kind of like guys they weren't pushing, but gave them a gimmick that you know, that they used to, and were kind of putting other people over, kind of got over with it as well. And then, you know, he had real bad drug problems. I guess he claimed it was from, he got a broken jaw in a match with Samoa Joe, and continued to work on it for a little while, and then they did an angle where it was said that Nigel McGuinness broke his jaw, since I guess that was the storyline they were going for. So this is 2007, maybe, in that range. And then, and I don't know if that's where I know he said it started, but it got bad. You know, it cost him his job, cost him his career, and indirectly, probably cost him his life. And, yeah, it's 39 years old. Just turned 39, I believe. 4 days ago, right? Or 5 days ago.
December 8th.
Yeah.
December 8th. Yeah, he had started in 1999. So he would have been, 16, 17 years old when he started. So, I mean, he was around.
Yeah, he was really young when he started, yeah.
And 39 years old. Passed away. So
did you know him?
I knew him at the end. I didn't know him a lot during his career, but over the last probably 4 or 5 months, we'd gone back and forth a lot, not really obviously about wrestling, but just more about all of the personal things. So yeah. I hadn't heard from him for a little while, but I'd talked to him a fair amount recently, and it was rough.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds horrible. I mean, losing your arm, losing your career, then losing your legs. I mean, must have been going through amazing, you know, an amazing amount of depression. I'm pretty sure that I met him, but I didn't know him or anything like that. I think that I met him at a, you know, show years and years ago, because I seem to remember talking to him, but it's not, I didn't know him or anything, so it's hard for me to say much about him on a personal level. I mean, he was, you know, I mean, he was one of those guys when he started that you thought could go either way, in the sense that, you know, because he was good when he was young and really brash and everything, but it didn't happen, and, you know, the drug issues cost him jobs on more than one occasion, and he admitted it. It's not like I'm saying something that people didn't know. He was very public with it later in his career, you know, and so, but I don't know what else to say about it, really.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts, and also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.